Now that it's full-on summer, you may be wondering what outfit you can work out in that feels comfortable when you get all sweaty so you're not like too hot and sticky. Well, in my next video, I share 3 outfits to work out in when the weather gets really hot. Stick around and watch. Hey there, I'm Alicia. Welcome back to my channel. Today I am doing a fashion video, which may seem a little different from my other videos, which are usually fitness oriented, but I'm not sure if you knew this about me or not, but in my day job, I am a stylist. I actually work on photo shoots and commercials, and I work with private clients. And actually, I just launched my virtual closet cleanse service, which means that I can work with anybody in the world as long as they have an internet connection. So I'm gonna put the link to that down below if you're interested in contacting me for a virtual closet cleanse so we can go through what you have in your closet, get rid of the stuff that no longer works, and figure out what you're gonna wear so that you can look like your best self. Anyhow, back to the video. Today I'm talking about workout outfits to wear when the weather gets really hot. In New York, we just had this heat wave. It was in the 90s for several days in a row, and yesterday was one of those days, and to work out, to go to my class, I put on my regular tights. I don't know if I didn't check the weather or what I was thinking, but I put on my regular tights to work out in, and I got all sweaty, and it just felt awful. Like, peeling them off of my body was just a miserable experience. So that inspired me to go get some new workout clothes that I could wear when it gets really hot outside that will just work better with sweat. So that, what's that called? Like moisture wicking fabric, fabrics that dry really quickly, and things like this. I've got 3 different looks that I got from 3 different places, and I'm just gonna go through them and let's get to it. The first outfit I got was from The Gap, very basic tee and shorts. The tee felt kind of oversized, so I tried to tie it in a knot, but I didn't like the way it became a crop top when I lift my arms up. So I settled on tying it in the back to give it a little bit more of a figure flattering effect, and that seemed to work pretty well. When I lifted my arms up, it didn't rise up and become a crop top anymore. So I'm trying it out with some yoga. Here I try my Warrior 3. And because, you know, a lot of people don't really wear shorts in yoga. Shorts is really big for runners, but yoga and in fitness classes like bar, boot camp, you don't really see people wearing these kinds of shorts, which, you know what, who cares? It's really hot outside and shorts are a great option when the weather is really hot. So I did some squats, and these shorts were actually pretty cool because they had this lining on the inside, which really made me feel a little bit more protected, like no one was gonna be able to see up my shorts. So overall, this outfit, I really liked it. It was comfortable and cute. The next look came from Lululemon, and I'm gonna be honest, I really didn't wanna get anything from Lululemon because it's really expensive and it's just so expected. But there's a reason why everyone shops at Lululemon. They have really good options, especially for yoga and fitness classes. They have all the breathable fabrics. So that's why everybody buys Lululemon. So I went in and I bought this outfit, and it really was not my style. I usually don't get so decked out in my workout wear, but when in Lululemon, you know, I went for it. So this outfit had a high waist, which it works with the crop top. I mean, it covers my belly. You don't really see that much more. Here's my Warrior 3. The pants do not help you balance better, just to make that clear. So yeah, it is high-waisted pants, which help with the crop top, but there is still some skin showing. But this was really a flowy, breathable fabric with the shirt. It was very cool, and these pants felt really good as I was moving around and exercising. And by the way, I am listening to music here. If you're wondering why is she bouncing like a crazy lady, I am jamming to this new Spoon song, which I'm really into at the moment. So this Lululemon outfit, it made me feel pretty good. The fabrics were comfortable, and I can see why these kinds of clothes do really well in the studios, because that's what they were made for. This last look came from Lou and Gray, and it's actually kind of an athleisure look. I think I would wear this in my day-to-day. When I saw the top on the hanger, I was like, oh, not so sure. But when I put it on, I actually thought it was really flattering, and the fabric felt really good. I tied this up in the knot again, which, as you can tell, I seem to do with all my workout clothes, and I'm trying it out with my tree. This outfit was super comfortable. These pants were so good. They were baggy, which I think is really good in the heat. It's the opposite of what the tights do, which I mentioned how they just get really sticky to your skin, but this fabric was loose and I could clearly move very freely. I got into my jumping jacks. I can see that the top went into that crop top, which I really don't like to do, so I adjusted it. And I think it looked really good. The fabrics on these pieces were definitely breathable, and I could tell they would dry really quick if I got super sweaty. It's not really usual to see this type of look in a yoga class or a fitness class, but because the fabrics were so light and breathable, why not? If it works, then wear it. I did get a second option, which was a tank top that this had the perfect length, and I really liked being sleeveless. It felt really good. I think that would work really well when it's 90 degrees. This was more of a gray color, so I thought it was a nice option aside from black. And this would also work really well taking me from the studio to the street. That's it. Thanks for watching. Please hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe. I will see you next week. Bye.